hearty welcome to our online class, class 8, subject science. Today in crop production and management unit we are going to see two different topics. One is the foliar spray and biocontrol methods. First we shall see what is meant by foliar spray. It is a technique of feeding plants by applying liquid fertilizer directly to their leaves. So it is nothing but a technique where we are applying the liquid fertilizer directly on the leaves of plants or trees. Plants are able to absorb essential elements through the stomata in their leaves, but total absorption takes place only through the epidermis. And sea-based plant mixes from kelp contains trace nutrients and some hormones which are used for the development of plant leaves, flowers and fruit. And this foliar spray will be generally done only during the early morning or in the late evening. So what is meant by foliar spray? It is a technique of applying liquid fertilizer directly on the leaves of plants or trees. So here if you see the next one, effective microorganism technology. Effective microorganism technology, it is a culture of different effective microbes commonly occurring in nature. Nitrogen fixers, phosphate stabilizer, photosynthetic microorganism, lactic acid bacteria, yeast, rhizobacteria and various fungi and actinomycetes are used as effective microorganisms. So mainly in case of effective microorganism technology, they are using various microorganisms like nitrogen fixers, phosphate stabilizer, photosynthetic microorganism, lactic acid bacteria, yeast and rhizobacteria. In this consortium, each microorganism has its own beneficial role in nutrient cycling, plant protection, soil health and fertility enrichment. The microorganisms will play the major role in effective microorganism technology. And next one, vermiwash. It is a liquid that is collected after the passage of water through a column of warm action. It is a collection of excretory product and mucus secretion of earthworm along with micronutrients from the soil organic molecules. It is used as a foliar spray for crops. So vermiwash is a liquid that is collected after the passage of water through a column of warm action. And next one, panchagavya. It is nothing but the word panch refers to five in Hindi. So it is a collection of five products obtained from cow. And the products, these five products are obtained mainly from the cow, that is cow dung, cow's urine, milk, curd and ghee. They are said to be panchagavya. All the five products are collectively named as panchagavya. It has the potential to play the role of promoting growth and providing immunity booster. It provides resistance to pests and increase the overall yield. It can be prepared by the farmers themselves with the material available on the farm. So these are all the five panchagavya: cow dung, cow's urine, ghee, milk and curd. They are said to be panchagavya. And next one, biocontrol method. It is a biological control method of controlling pests like insects, mites, weed and plant disease using other organisms, biopredators, biopesticide, biorepellent and biofertilizer are used for controlling microorganisms which cause damage to the crops, pests and insects. So in case of biocontrol method, the first one is biopredator. They are naturally occurring insects that use pests for feeding or multiplication. By introducing large number of predators in a greenhouse, we can destroy the pest. Predators like chrysopus and menaceals are highly useful in controlling a wide variety of pests like aphids, whiteflies, cotton bollworms, leaf insects, etc. So next one, biopesticide. They are living organism or their derived parts which are used as biocontrol agents to protect the crops against insect pests. So it is also a method in which they are using living organism or their derived parts to control, to protect the crops against insect pests. And next one, there are of two different types. One is fungal biopesticide and second type is bacterial biopesticide. In case of fungal biopesticide, it is useful to control various disease caused by fungi such as wilt, rusting of leaf and root disease. While in case of bacterial biopesticide, it is a culture of Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria is effectively used to control the pest Lepidoptera that attack cotton, maize plants. And next one, biorepellent. A compound, a chemical compound named azadirachtin is obtained from the seeds of neem. It is used as a good biorepellent. One of the earliest pesticide used by man was margosa leaves. The dried leaves repel the pest from stored grains. And the last one, biofertilizer. They are the organisms which can bring about soil nutrient enrichment. Nitrogen fixing microorganisms have the capability of converting free nitrogen into nitrogenous compounds and make the soil fertile. The main source of biofertilizer is cyanobacteria and certain fungi. Although the chemical fertilizers increase food production, they degrade the natural habitat. Free living bacteria live freely in the soil and fix atmospheric nitrogen and make it available to the crops like cereals, millets, fruits and vegetables. For example, Azospirillum, free living cyanobacterium which involves in the nitrogen fixation along with the photosynthesis. And some other examples like Anabina, Nostoc, symbiotic bacteria fix atmospheric nitrogen. For example, we can say Rhizobium. They will act as, or they do fix the bacteria and they are helpful for the soil fertility also. It is an example for biofertilizer. So in our today's session, we have seen two different topics. One is the biocontrol method and the second topic is foliar spray. Thank you, children.